this is the dev team. Today we will show you how to create similar images like in the Chaos Extra library. We will explain how to create illustrations using neural network divided into layers and animate with the parallax effect in Figma. Go to Pinterest and find an image by the artist Benny Bishop. The link is in the description. Right-click on the image and select Copy Image Address. Midjourney. We need the Midjourney bot. If you haven't used Midjourney before, check out the video in description. It explains how to start using Midjourney in detail. Type in the prompt and add the Pinterest image link, as well as user interface, comma, website --ar1629. Generate options until you like it, and that can be divided into layers easily. We like this option. Save it. Photoshop. Go to Photoshop Beta. As of September 2023, the AI Firefly feature is only available in beta version. If you haven't used it before, you can activate the free trial period on the Adobe website. To get the similar result, follow the hotkey combinations that we use. Step 1. Add a brush. Select the brush tool and right-click. Among the brushes, right-click again and select Import Brush. Choose the brush we have created for this path. Scroll to the bottom and select the Add Brush. Step 2. Remove the excess. Select the Polygonal Lasso tool and select all the areas where there are artifacts and unfinished edges. Click on Generative Fill. Generate. Wait for Photoshop to generate three options. Choose one of three options. Merge both layers into one. Use the Patch tool to align the seams that we formed during neural network generation. Step 3. The image needs to be divided into layers in perspective. We will use channels to select. The first and closest layer will be the eyes. To do this, we need to create maximum contrast. Create an additional layer with a black and white filter and adjust so that the eyes are as contrast as possible against the background. Then create a blank layer and fill in everything around the eyes. Add the levels filter and move the black slider a little. Then open the channels tab. Click on the image preview with the command key pressed on Windows Control. Return to the layers tab. Turn off all filter layers. Select the layer with our image and press command J on Windows Control J. Now you have cut out the exact silhouette of the first layer. Delete unnecessary layers. Select the layer with image. The layer with the eyes is turned off. Use the lasso tool to select the eyes. Click on Generate Fill. Generate. Merge the generated background with the image. Next, we need to separate the silhouette of the head. Create Levels filter. Adjust it to create contrast between the layers. Create a blank layer. Add a black and white filter layer. Select the blank layer. Use the brush we added to paint over everything that is not part of this layer, in our case the silhouette of the head. Then go to the channels tab. Select the area by hovering over the preview with the command key pressed. Now we need to invert the selected area because the white was selected. To do this, press command plus I. Turn off all filter layers. Select the background layer. Use the command J hotkey to cut out the contents into a new layer. There are some artifacts on the silhouette, so we duplicate the layer and merge them with command E. As a result, now we have two layers in perspective. Delete filter layers. Select the background. Use the lasso tool to select the silhouette of the head. Generate the background. Choose one of the options that the neural network offers. They are all normal, so you can choose any. We will do the same for all other layers. Merge the background layers. Select the mountain silhouette that we will cut out. Create filter layers, black and white and level. adjust the contrast. On a new layer, use the brush that we have added to paint over everything that is not needed, in our case the mountain silhouette. Go to the channels tab and select the area. Invert it. Select the background layer and copy the selections to a new layer. Duplicate it and merge. Select the background layer. Select the mountains on it and generate the image. We will do the same for two more layers. We now have 6 layers. The first layer is text, then 5th, 4th, 3rd, 2nd and 1st. Now save each layer separately in PNG format. In the file name we write the layer number. This is necessary so that when we add files to Figma, the highest layer will have the highest numerical number and we don't have to arrange the layers manually. Transfer all our files to Figma, select them, and align them vertically and horizontally. Move the layers into a frame, select the Scale tool. Scale all the layers so that they can go beyond the boundaries of the frame. Select the frame and choose the plugin Parallax. And then we just start moving the mouse in the plugin and we get the Parallax effect. If necessary, we can add any interface details, text, and get a template or website homepage. You can export this parallax in the following formats: HTML as a demonstration for developers, in SVG format, GIF and PubMed formats can be added to the Figma prototype, but they will not be interactive. Thank you for your attention. Hope this tutorial was helpful for you. Write in the comments what difficulties you faced while following this principle and if you learned something new. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. We will try to upload more useful content for you. See you soon!